Welcome to episode 18 of the Miami Marlins franchise on MLB The Show 21. Today we have some mega trades getting made, some that could make or break your interest in the rest of the series. This is monumental for the series. I hope that you guys will enjoy the trades. They will all be explained. Trade deadline episode coming to you now. Don't go anywhere. And into this trade deadline episode, we're going to start with something other than the trade, as Brian Anderson has 3 years of arbitration after this year, but he's only making $3 million, and I gotta think that the arbiter is going to give him more with the way he's been playing over the last few seasons. He's probably going to be in the range of $3.5 million, maybe $4 million player, depending on what we offer him. He obviously has been very good for us and is a player that I think could be the old man on a championship-winning team, but he didn't want to take the $6 million a year offer or the $6.2 million a year offer, so I'm hoping that he'll take the $6.5 million a year offer over the next five. There it is. Keeps Anderson on the team for the next 5 years till he's 33 years old. Bobby Bradley is a player we were very much interested in potentially bringing in. I know Jesus Aguilar is a bit of a fan favorite, but he's getting older and probably isn't on a World Series winning team for this Marlins franchise. So Bobby Bradley offered to us for Shane Green. Now, I mean, look, I can't help what the computer's going to offer me. If they want Shane Green, they can have him. There you go, Indians. And then further into that, Mike Trout offered with Franklin Barreto for Christian Pache, Brendan Rodgers, and Howard Burt. I mean, if that's what you're going to offer me, I'm probably going to take it. I know this is going to be very divisive amongst you watching, but I mean, to have a Trout swimming with the Marlins, come on, who could say no to that? Mike Trout is, by the way, having a down year, which we will get to at the end of the episode, so stay tuned. Please don't click away. Lucas Sims, we obviously gave away a reliever, so why not bring one back with Jesus Aguilar, who we no longer need, and Jeff Mathis, who they will take and I no longer need because Alfaro has come back off the injured list. Ryan McMahon as a backup first base slash third baseman to get rid of Jose Peraza, who pretty much does a lot of different things, but Peraza going to be reaching free agency soon, and we're likely not paying him. So I think that's a good deal for us as well. A 19-year-old, very nice potential first baseman in Peter Welch we bring to the team. And he maybe could be a first baseman of the future if Bobby Bradley doesn't work out. The Orioles are willing to give up Casey Golden for a bunch of prospects who I don't think are going to work out long-term in this franchise. And Casey Golden, that man can hit. He can field a little bit, and he can run a bit, so he looks like he could potentially be a five-tool left fielder for us in the future, and we wanted to bring more building blocks in, aside from, of course, the already established players that we have and had brought in already. Now, because we have Sixto Sanchez on the injured list for a long time this season, it's going to be Alexis Sanchez's time to come up to the Major League squad and see what he can do. That being said, now a starting pitcher missing from AAA, and it is Jordan Holloway's time. He hasn't been perfect since the All-Star break, but I'd like to see what he can do. Now, looking at the injured list, yep, Sixto Sanchez likely going to come off of the 15-day and go right on to the 60-day because he's got a while to go before he's ready to come back. Nelly Cruz likely won't come back for 1 to 2 months, nor will Nick Neidert or Cameron Misner, so big problems there. But I think this lineup is ready to make a playoff push. We were big-time buyers at the deadline here in this episode. Only 2.5 games out of the postseason. We'd like to get the Marlins there. And I think with these moves, we make them pretty heavy favorites to potentially maybe come back and take the division away from the Mets, the Phillies, the Nationals, the Braves. These teams really giving a big push towards the postseason. And man, we've got some dangerous hitters here. Nico Goodrum will play against lefties. Birdie will play against righties at second base. The starting rotation isn't much different than what it has been. Sixto hasn't been playing, so Max Meyer, of course, in there with a laser. Hernandez getting that spot instead of being in long relief, so that's where Alexis Sanchez will start his major league career. We'll see what he can do over in the long relief in the bullpen. Garrett Crochet and Guillermo Marquez both setting up Roberto Osuna. I think that sets up very well for us, potentially to close out the 7th, 8th, and 9th innings if need be. So let's see what the first game after these trades looks like. The Tampa Bay Rays coming in at 53-42. We are 51-43. So let's see what we can do. Pablo Lopez on the mound for us today. 6-6 record, a 3.86 ERA, and a 1.12 whip. A pretty good season for Pablo Lopez, just not getting the dubs like we'd like to see. Yonny Chirinos will oppose him. 5-8 with a 4.28 ERA and a 1.29 whip, so he's had a worse season for sure. Here we are on throwback day at South Beach Park. Let's see how this one goes. Bottom of the first inning, John Birdie down the right field line, and that one going to get past the right fielder. A little bit of a misplay, and you can't do that with John Birdie on the bags. That's an instant triple for him getting past the outfielder. Michael Conforto comes up and laces one up the middle. Chirinos gets out of the way real quick, and Michael Conforto with an RBI single. Now in the two-hole for Conforto. This is a very dangerous lineup. Here's Javi Baez. He strikes out with the bases loaded, and that's two away in the bottom of the first. Bobby Bradley comes up, and he strikes out as well. So not working out. This big-time lineup left three on base there. But into the bottom of the third we go, and this is a big hit out to the right field wall. Eloy Jimenez getting himself on second base with a double. That sets up for Javi Baez, and that single up the middle will single home Eloy Jimenez for the second run of the ballgame. 2-0 Miami Marlins over the Rays in the bottom of the third. That'll take us all the way into the top of the seventh. No change in score. Pablo Lopez getting squeezed. He'll walk a batter. And then this hit right past Bobby Bradley at first base. He lets that one go through. So now two on with two away. Pablo Lopez trying to get through this seventh inning. And this dribbler, nice stop by Birdie, but he cannot make any outs. So the bases are loaded with two away. A two-out rally here for the Rays. And here is a dribbler on to short. Nice play for Baez on the throw on to second. And Lopez gets through the inning. Here's Mike Trout with his first base hit as a Marlin. And it is into center field for a single with two away in the seventh. That gives Eloy Jimenez a shot to bring him home, and that is a launcher out to left field and caught at the wall. Beautiful catch. And we remain at 2-0. Manny Pena up at the plate, and this one down the right field line in the eighth as Lopez still in this game, trying to throw on to second, maybe get Pena out, but it's not in time. He will be in there with a double, his sixth of the season. Here's Manuel Margot pinch hitting. He gets the single into center field, and that will bring home Manny Pena for the Rays' first run of the game, which cuts the lead in half from 2-1. Alejandro Zepeda coming in to pitch for the Rays. He hasn't had the greatest of seasons, and it's not really getting any better here in the bottom of the eighth. Brian Anderson gets a single to lead off the bottom of the eighth. And then Javi Baez coming up, and he's jammed, inside jam, but that will land for a bloop single in right field. So two on, nobody away for Bobby Bradley, who smacks one out to left field, and that one gets over the wall this time. Nobody catching that at the wall. Bobby Bradley's first home run as a Miami Marlin. His 11th of the season, went 369 nice feet. and Bobby Bradley making his welcome to South Beach Park. Nice standing ovation at the park for him. Everybody waiting to greet him and give him a high five. And Garrett Crochet coming into the ninth inning. We don't need much here. It's not a save opportunity at 5-1, so give Crochet his shot, and Ian Happ goes down. Strike number three, two away in the top of the ninth. Here's Michael Brousseau, and he is going to pop fly behind the catcher, behind the plate, and there is the catch to end the game. 5-1, the Marlins get a win here. First game since all of these trades. Mike Trout picks up his first win as a Marlin. We are saving him from the LA Angels. It's not often you get an opportunity to do this. Usually in years past, MLB The Show would not let you pick up Mike Trout for literally anything you would trade. But this year's trade logic is actually worse when they said it was going to be better. I can't really help that. All I can do is have fun with it. So I'm sorry if you can't understand, but as a content creator, it can be monotonous to do the same thing over and over again. And I mean, there's no guarantee we're going to win with Mike Trout. Like I said, he's having a bad down year in Sim already. And look, Adalberto Mondesi gets picked up for not much here. I realize he's not Mike Trout, but it's not like they're really giving up anything. At least we gave up two A potential star prospects that everybody figures are going to be good starters in the majors at some point. Now we'll go to Blue River Stadium. The Durham Bulls coming in to take on the Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp, and it is Jordan Holloway's first start in AAA, coming up from AA to 6'6", 230-pound, 25-year-old, a potential pitcher, and he pitched really, really well in AA this season, going 7-2 before being brought up, and we're hoping he can have some success here in AAA, and right away in the first inning, going to walk a batter with one away. Here's Mark Archer at the plate, going to pitch out, try to get the steal at second, and cannot gun him down. So a runner in scoring position, Holloway with another walk in the first. A little off-keister here today, but this liner caught by the first baseman gets him through the first inning, and we'll see how he progresses throughout this game. Michael Lantigua, clearly new to AAA as well. He's had one start with a 1.13 ERA and a 0.5 whip, so he's been really, really good for the Durham Bulls, who, of course, lead the division here that the Jumbo Shrimp are a part of and likely will be postseason bound, where the Jumbo Shrimp will likely not. And there's Lantigua getting a freeze on a backwards K. Here's Jordan Holloway, and there's the strikeout on the fastball up and in. He doesn't like it, but probably should have swung. His second strikeout of the day. Then this one is taken deep out to right field, but not deep enough, as that is caught to end the top of the fourth. And Holloway running through the fourth without giving up anything. But there hasn't been any runs scored here. And off of Lantigua, this one's just over the wall and gone over the right field wall for Eason Diaz. If you were hoping to see Eason Diaz potentially make it to the majors, there's his potential right there. Five homers on the season for Diaz. And that solo shot giving our Jumbo Shrimp a 1-0 lead. So good to see Diaz doing some things. Here's Jazz Chisholm in the bottom of the fifth inning off of Lantigua. And that is a piss missile all the way up against the wall out in right center field. Chisholm's going to try for three bags, and he is going to get there. So Jazz Chisholm with a great triple. That'll bring in Rolandi Baldwin, and this is a bloop single into right that Chisholm does not score on. That'll bring up Monte Harrison, and he gets this one going up the middle. Diving stop. They do throw out Monte Harrison, they give up the run as Chisholm comes in. Here's Miguel Giraldo, and this one right back at the pitcher to end the fifth inning. But the Jumbo Shrimp hold a 2-0 lead. Here's Vidal Brujan just taking the strike three call. He's a little mad, but only Holloway's third strikeout. That brings us into the ninth, where Ryan Muller will get a chance to close this one out. 24 saves and 27 opportunities. Been very good against right-handed batting. but not so much against lefties. Here's a lefty at the plate. This is a dribbler right up the middle and thrown on to first for out number one here in the ninth inning. Now Will Craig at the plate, a full count. This one dribbled. First baseman handles it, tosses it over to Muller, and gets the second out of this ninth inning. Kevin Smith now up at the plate. He swings at something out of the zone and gets it past the second baseman. And there we go. They got their runner on. The potential tying run at the plate, dribbling it on to short. Quick toss over to second, and that does it. A shutout of the Durham Bulls. The division leaders getting shut out here against the home team, Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp. Ryan Muller's very excited about it. And it is a 2-0 win. So good to see Jordan Holloway getting player of the game in his first start, probably getting the game ball, 8 innings pitched, doing a really nice job. No earned runs. You'll love to see it. Lantigua gives up 2 earned in his 6 innings. Still not a bad start to his AAA career, as he has a 1.93 ERA. But Holloway with the 0 ERA, and it's going to be tough to make it climb as he has pitched 8 innings. So a really nice start for our boy Jordan Holloway. Now we get a chance to jump into this game, but no chance I'm doing that. We were already killing them. So a 10-2 win, then a 4-0 win against Washington. Xavier Marchant will be out for a few days, which isn't too serious of an injury. This is good. We can keep him active and move on. So the final game against Washington, a chance to sweep them. Here's Javi Baez in the bottom of the ninth with two on. He gets a single into right. They're going to call him home from third, bring him in, and an easy score and an easy win here in the bottom half as Golden called up to the majors. He gets a start in this game, and Golden coming home to give the Marlins the win. Mike Trout, player of the game, he was 1-for-1 with a homer and a ribby. He hit the solo shot. Roberto Osuna gets the win. So Mike Trout probably called in as a pinch hitter today, I'm pretty sure that means. Jonathan Scope got both RBIs for the Nationals. And yep, Mike Trout, pinch hit homer, pinch hit solo shot. Javi Baez hit a double. Trout, Jimenez, and Baez with the ribbies. Baez, of course, with the winning hit. So now we move into a series against the Chicago Cubs. And we take 2 out of 3, so good. Now moving into a big section of August here, going up against all of our divisional rivals. And here you can see Mike Trout just having a down year. Compare this to all of his numbers. This is not Mike Trout numbers. 20 homers, 56 ribbies, only batting .262. It's just not really Mike Trout numbers, honestly. If you look at everything he's ever done, playing 100 games already, and just not really performing like the superstar player he is. We're hoping we can revitalize him this season, get him back to where he should be by the end of the year. Clearly was not happy in LA with the Angels. After signing a big deal with them, he would have liked to have won a ring with them, but the Angels just not getting the pitching when he wanted it on the team. And all in all, he's going to be a lot happier here with the Marlins, who now under my GMship are always trying to win regardless of budget. He actually fit underneath our budget, got a chance to talk to Derek Jeter and make sure that he could give us that extra little bit of cash just to be able to spread it out to Mike Trout. But of course, we had to get rid of some of the other parts on the team that were costing some money, like Jesus Aguilar had to be dumped off and some other things. But we found a way to fit it in, and we are still a few games back of the division. We are still not there. We are 7-3 in our last 10 games, all of those games with Mike Trout. So playing well, but still 2.5 games back of the wild card. So there's no guarantee this is going to work, and we might have to blow some things up in the offseason, but we are going for it. We think we have the team that could get us into the postseason, and when we get into the postseason, we're going to be a tough out. So hopefully this will take us where we want to go. Jumbo Shrimp 14 games out, and the Blue Wahoos just 2 games out in AA, but they'll no longer have Jordan Holloway. So you can let me know in the comments section below your true feelings, please. You're not going to hurt my feelings because I'm going to do what I'm going to do. It's my channel, my series, my fun. I want to have fun with it. Hopefully you'll have fun with it. And we'll see. We'll be continuing to monitor how Mike Trout plays here and all of that. So if you guys really want to support this series, support this channel as a whole, make sure you drop a like on the video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. If you are new to the channel and love franchise content, that is what we do here. And if you wouldn't mind hitting that share button and sharing it to Twitter, sharing it to Instagram, sharing it to literally anywhere you can, Facebook, anywhere you guys have, I would really greatly appreciate it. If you want to see some more franchise, make sure you click right here to see some more franchise.